Unresolved problem segment tonight, outrageous decision-making in some of America's public schools. In Kentucky, the High School Athletic Association has banned post-game handshakes at athletic events. This because so many brawls among players developed after the games. In Port Washington, New York, near where I live, the Weber Middle School has banned footballs, baseballs, soccer balls, and any recreational equipment they think might hurt somebody. Dr. Kathleen Mooney, the superintendent, says that we want to make sure our children have fun, but are also protected. Protected from what? Life. With us now, Bob Bowdon, the executive director of Choice Media, and educational website. What the heck is really going on here? What's behind all this?
I think there are two polar problems here, which both can be true at the same time. There can be what I call the wussification of American schools. This means you have things like handshake bans happening, and you're talking about banning footballs, other schools that have banned peanut butter. In fact, even a suspension of a kid just earlier this month in Rhode Island who had a two-inch keychain token. It's like a gun token on his keychain. 2 inches. Banned for 3 days, suspended for three days.
And we see those stories all over where little kids, 7, 8, you know, they're pantomiming the shooting
with the
and
finger.
They're suspended.
Indeed.
But I'm not getting the big picture here. I taught at school, but it was in a private school, high school. All right. What is the goal, in your opinion? Now, we're talking generally because each school district is different. But there's a trend here. You can't have footballs and baseballs because somebody might get hurt. I mean, life is somebody might get hurt.
Right.
So what is the trend? To just neuter everything?
Right.
Is that what it is?
Well, yeah, and I would say participation trophies because we're worried about the fragile egos of our little princes and princesses if they might actually lose in a game. We don't want to damage their self-esteem. Self-esteem in some ways elevated to be more important than learning to lose with some sort of grace. But there's also another problem, which is real violence that actually also happens in
schools. And that's what Kentucky. That's what happened
Indeed.
In Kentucky. Because they're brawling after the games, and when you have the handshake, they come together and they start to beat each other up. Okay, so on one hand, you have an increasing amount of violence, and on the other hand, the school authorities are saying you can't have a soccer ball because it might hit you in the nose. It doesn't seem to be any consistency here at all.
I think part of it is an overreaction to the attention to bullying in schools, which was deserved, a conversation that needed to happen. But like many social trends, there are those who then take the pendulum too far in the other direction.
But how would you bullying, you know, a football bullies you? A baseball bullies you?
No, but
this
you had,
is just crazy stuff.
No, but you had a girl last month in Florida who killed herself, a 12-year-old girl.
But there is a real bullying, and the internet drives that now worse than it was when you and I were in school in the schoolyard, where at least you could fight back. But I'm not getting it, and maybe the viewers can help me out with some mail. What the prevailing wisdom is on the part of the superintendents? What do they want in their school? Do they want a bunch of zombies who just go in like this and never compete or never take a chance? Is that what they want?
Well, they're afraid of lawsuits. Let's not forget that.
Well, boards have lawyers. They pay lawyers to defend.
But they pay more when they lose cases or when they settle cases.
You know, it was the same when we were in school. There were always lawsuits.
Not as many as there are now. But I would also say, too, that the schools of education are playing a part here, too, where they're teaching prospective teachers, the teachers of tomorrow, a kind of philosophy of competition can be bad if it creates losers.
Now, that's interesting. So you believe in the nation's colleges that are training the teachers and administrators. The philosophy is touchy-feely, and the urchins need to be protected from everything.
I would not call them bastions of capitalism, the defense of the philosophy of capitalism.
Or,
exactly.
Or competition.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
They don't want that.
They don't want that.
They want nurturing.
Indeed. If you have a top-down bureaucratic educational model, it's certainly not based on competition.
Right.
It's based
and the solution is to have more school choice, I guess, right?
That's certainly a solution where parents could find whatever level of discipline fits their kid.
That's right.
And even in the same family, siblings might call for different levels of competition.
So there could be public charter schools that do allow baseballs. And then one that don't.
Indeed, yeah, the radical
baseball school
schools.
And then the baseball school.
That's right.
All right, it's insane. All right, Mr. Bowdon, thanks for coming in. We appreciate it.